Underneath a stunning ceiling at the Colombo Lodge, a group of familiar royal faces practices a dance routine. Rapunzel, Flynn, Prince Charming, and Cinderella are counting the days until the Winter Wonderland Royal Ball on January 25th.
Dancing is one of my favorite things to do. I love balls. I have balls at my castle all the time, and I love dancing with my Prince Charming, and he gets to come to the ball with me, so I'm going to love dancing with him.
I trust that my princess is looking incredible, as usual. So that is always quite a blessing for me.
Other classic fairy tale princesses will join this group of royals for a fun night filled with dancing, food, and fun for children and children at heart, complete with special dance numbers.
I think the thing I'm most excited about is being able to show everyone our new dances. We've been working on some dances, courtesy of Cinderella. She choreographed them. And I'm very excited for everyone to see how well the Beast and I have been dancing lately.
I'm fairly athletic, lots of climbing buildings and all kinds of stuff. So the dance wasn't too difficult, but definitely not my area of expertise.
Kids are so wonderful. I mean, I met nobody in my tower, so meeting anybody is wonderful.
The ball promises to be a whimsical and fun evening, up close and personal with some popular princesses.
This year, because of the Frozen movie coming out and everything like that, we decided that the new princess and the new queen were going to be the hosts of this ball, so I invited them and they agreed to come. So Elsa is actually going to be doing her very favorite song during the ball, so she's going to be performing that. And then we just sent out all the invitations to the other princesses, and most of them decided that they could join us, which is really exciting.
It's really quite fun, actually. We get to put on our beautiful favorite dresses and do our hair up our favorite way, and then we get to come see everyone, and everyone tells us how beautiful we are, and we are so flattered because they are just as beautiful.
Everyone's going to come in, and they're actually going to be seated by the princes. They've decided they're going to be escorting everyone to their tables. We always start off with an opening performance to greet everyone. All the princesses and princes join in that. And then the food will be served, and Colombo Lodge is absolutely amazing. It's actually kingdom-style dinner. And then we just have open dance, all music that the kids are going to know. Even all the princes have actually got together, and they're going to do a boy band this year, which is really exciting. It's going to be great.
Stefanik says there's more to the ball than just showing kids a good time.
It's so important for little girls to know that their dreams can come true. You know, it's not an evil world out there. There is good in the world. And I really always want to focus on the fact that even though princesses are in their pretty dresses, they still go outside. They still have fun. I mean, take Rapunzel. She climbs towers and trees and all other sorts, you know, on her off time too. So, you know, and you can always come in, get your pretty dress on, and you can still be a princess. And it's okay to be a princess. And boys too, it's okay to be a prince, you know, and you can dream big, and, you know, you can be a princess and be a prince.
The event is hosted by River City Gymnastics, and tickets are available until January 18th. To find out where to get them or for more information, visit KamloopsPrincessParties.com. For Shaw TV, I'm Sam Numsen.